Hi guys and welcome back to Light Sandu TV. Today is Saturday the 25th of March. I was just going to say November, I don't know why. 25th of March, I had posted my last video on the book fair and this is my upcoming video. So I have a list because I was being very inconsistent. So I have jotted down a list of topics that I'll be doing some videos on and I'll try to be more regular. So today's video will be a Q&A session which I have actually been planning. Sorry, I just shook the table. I had actually been planning since 2018 but it just never happened. I didn't have proper setup. I still don't have proper setup right now. I'm using a very low priced tripod. I still don't have a ring light or anything. And I just have to manage with that. But I think as long as the quality and the content is fine, I think that should work. So I don't know how many of you know that there is a website called ask.fm where you can ask people questions anonymously. Yes, so I have an account there and a lot of strangers or maybe even known people, because I don't know their identity, they ask me questions. But just like YouTube, I'm very inconsistent on this app also. So I thought of why don't I integrate the two. Like, I will be answering questions which people have asked me on my YouTube channel. I think this will make it more interactive and more fun and entertaining to watch also. So the first question is from, this is not an anonymous user, it's from Shadon Gupta. She wrote, she's asking, Instagram Reels or Post? For me, I would prefer Post. I post more, still photos and Reel. Next question is, when will the COVID-19 end? I think COVID, the pandemic as such has already ended. The outbreak is, the rate of infection has reduced by a huge rate since 2020. So it's 2023 now. I think pretty much a lot of people are vaccinated, I feel. So it has ended, I would say. Not ended completely. People do get infected still, but no strict lockdown as such. The next question is from anonymous user. How to tell a girl moving alone on the road that I am single and available? You should not do that. That is not the proper etiquette. I don't have any freedom in life. Well, I'm assuming that in South Asia, a lot of parents and families are very strict. So if you are quite young, try to, get independent as fast as possible and try to move out. The next question is from another anonymous user. If a girl has a good looking face, can I stare? No, you can't. That is not the proper etiquette. The next question is from another anonymous user. Are you ready for the next lockdown? I am not too fond of lockdowns as I am a very outgoing person. I don't like to stay at home. So I like to, move around, explore the city, try explore different places in my city. So I'm not too fond of lockdowns. But if the need arises, then I can adjust. Will we ever be able to live life like pre-COVID? I think we already are. I don't, because I have been to a lot of restaurants, gyms, salons. Earlier, mask was a mandatory requirement, and even, hand sanitizers and such. I don't see those necessities anymore or those rules and regulations anymore. So I think we are, back to normal. Do we have to wear a mask lifelong? I don't know why these are all COVID related questions, but I don't think so. At least I don't wear mask in, majority of the time. Middle of a relationship crisis, need advice. Well, I'm also kind of in the same situation, and what I'm doing is just distract yourself, keep yourself occupied and take your time. So the brain, because I studied a little bit of psychology, I will explain here. The brain gets addicted, when a brain gets addicted to something, that particular something gives, you know, a rush of dopamine. So when that something or someone goes away, you feel the symptoms of withdrawal. You know, like, it can be even compared to a drug addiction. Why do people, you know, like drug addicts or alcohol addicts, when they don't get their way, they panic a lot and they get impatient. It's not just limited to drugs or alcohol or, you know, cigarettes or anything. It can be anything as such. It can be your mobile phone. It can be a television program. It can be your best friend. It can be a relationship. It can be anything which, you know, gives a feeling of addiction. When that thing goes away, your brain gets into a state of withdrawal. It feels like something is missing constantly. So there is no, like, you know, one way ticket to do this. If it's a very serious issue, then obviously you can, you know, go to a mental health care and they'll give you these antidepressant pills and all. But the best and the most natural way is just to take your time. The brain eventually gets back to normal. Without using yup, yes, do you need money? I guess so. Favorite web series? At the top of my head, I can think of The Umbrella Academy. Or even Lock and Key, like, I think these two will be having a tie-up. What's the best thing about your first love? That person is a very dedicated parent. Snapchat or Instagram? I'm more active on Instagram. When is your birthday? 1st of May. Mark the date and send me a gift. What is your educational background? So my highest qualification is that I did my bachelor's in marketing. Post a picture. Well, since this is a YouTube video, you can already see me on the screen. Ask FM or Snapchat? Ask FM. My ask.fm account is 5 years old. I am following 42,675 girls on Ask FM. What else can I do in life? Well, my Ask FM account is 10 years old. I started this in 2013 and it's 2023 now. But as I keep saying, I'm not very consistent or very addicted to this app. What else you can do is, I don't know, watch YouTube videos, Instagram, or start your own Instagram or YouTube. There are lots of things you can do. If the COVID-19 pandemic does not end, will I be locked inside my house for the rest of your life? As I said a while ago, it has, I think, pretty much ended. Not ended completely, but you don't have to be locked inside your house. Were you in a relationship before? Yes. Can we call people who travel from one country to another country? Beep, there's a slang word here. Because they spread variants of COVID-19 from one country to another. Well, I can say that... Sorry, I'm shaking the table. Well, I can say that you can tell them quite... you can call them quite irresponsible. Because in a situation where, you know, there was a pandemic or a virus outbreak going on, you should restrict your movement, which they were not doing. Life after marriage is fun. I am single. I have no comments on this. I mean, life after marriage can be fun if the person is of your choice and, you know, you resonate with your partner, but that is not always the case. So before getting married, just be careful. Did you ever attend university? I have attended college, if that's what you mean. What are you doing in your life for the last 2 years? I graduated in 2021 and I've been working since 2022. So before work, so I joined my workplace in April of last year, and before that I was working as a content writer in a different company, and I was also tutoring a lot of school students. So that has been my life in the past 2 years. In 2021 it was mainly tuition and college, and then it was office life. Yeah, that's it. Would you spend rupees 100 for 1000 coins on AskFM? No, I don't take, all these digital coins which we use in online games and apps very seriously. How long do I need to stay single? Sad life. Why don't you install Tinder or Bumble? What lifelong restrictions do you have in your life due to another COVID question? COVID-19 pandemic. I am locked inside my house for the last 2 years. As I said in multiple questions before, I feel the COVID outbreak has reduced to a great extent. You don't have to be locked inside your house. When you were little, what game was your favorite? Is this video game or outdoor game or board games? Speaking of board games, I would say Snake and Ladder was my most played game. And if this is video game, then Samantha Swift and Visual 2D Lux and Luxor. And outdoor games, if you're talking about, then I think we used to play Lock and Key the most in our school life during the PTE recess and all. What type of restrictions do you have in your life? I'm not allowed to go out and enjoy. I have never done a night out with my friends as such, but apart from that, I think everything else is pretty much fine. Next question. So all of these are, by the way, anonymous users, I think. The game question was asked by Somya. Okay, and these are anonymous users. Can you stay up all night? Yes, I can. I have done it quite a few times. How was your Valentine's Day? I gave a heart-shaped red velvet cake to my Valentine on Valentine's Day, and a chocolate. And so if you go to my Instagram, you can see that I have a highlight. That person has shared it on stories. You like 90s songs? I'm not too fond of old songs. What are you most thankful for today? That I am in a better place than a lot of people in the world. Okay, by the way, there are lots of questions, so I'm restricting this to a 20-minute video. I can already see it's 30 minutes. If one day you wake up and get to hear that you have to spend 3 days without the internet, what would you do? Probably read books, listen to music, self-care, and draw, maybe. This question is asked by Ariana, and the previous question was asked by Akshi, by the way. Soumya is asking, who has your heart? I gave that person a code name. The code name is Sky. Farina Khan Qureshi is asking, what is the purpose of life? I would say different people have different purpose. Everyone has a role to play, for the greater good. So it's up to you. You have to figure out what is your purpose in life. Your current, Soumya is asking you my current mood. So I'm pretty excited, and this is the first time I'm doing a Q&A video. Another question that Soumya is asking, what is your favorite junk food? At the top of my head, I can think of fish cutlets. I've been having a lot of fish cutlets lately. If you were, Sarah Zotso is asking, if you were immortal, how would you live your life? Life never stays constant. life keeps on changing. There is always a flow, you know. So there is no one particular answer to this question, that this is how I spend my life. Song you have been listening on loop. The song Walk, W-A-L-K, Walk by Griff. This is my latest favorite. Anonymous user is asking how to get into a relationship with you. I have to think about this. I am saving myself for someone, but if you want to try, you can drop me a DM on Instagram. Say your crush's name. I just said Sky, S-K-Y. That's the nickname. What's your Snap score? I am assuming this has something to do with Snapchat, but I'm not very active on it. Soumya is again asking, so Soumya is asking a lot of questions to me. Soumya is asking your definition of an ideal partner. So people who are, considerate of others, I think that is my most favorite quality in a person. Freya is asking what are the qualities you want in your partner. I just answered that. What do you do to distract your mind? I watch YouTube videos or some web series, or just anything. Ariana is asking, what answer would you give to a person who always tries to put you down in front of others? So this is a very subjective question, and so you have to be very conscious of what, you know, what is going on around you, why someone is saying this, and what can this mean. And so this is something that I have been, you know, learning recently, and I would say there is a channel on YouTube. I would like to call out the name Smile with Prachi. So Smile with Prachi gives a lot of insight into, you know, questions like these, or life situations like these. So when someone is trying to say something which is a bit passive aggressive or kind of offensive, call that out immediately. Or you can also navigate in a slightly passive aggressive way. Just don't keep your mouth shut and don't tolerate it. That's all I would say. Like, for example, I'm giving you a real life example. In November, I was very sick, and my hair was messy. I had a facial hair in my neck, so I wasn't, grooming myself properly. And so there is a person who just commented that I wasn't, looking good. And as in the next day, what happened is I, cut my hair, I shaved my facial hair and all. So then the next time I met that person, she said, in Hindi, she said, I'm translating that in English, that, oh, today you are looking better. Last time you were not looking that good. It was in a very messy state. And this is a person who I don't know very well. So I kind of found that a bit offensive. So immediately I said, your hair is also so curly. You should try straightening it. You will also look good. So this is how I deal with people, when people make comments like this. Anonymous user is asking, I broke up with my boyfriend not so long ago and I started missing him. I know that I don't have any feelings for him, but why am I feeling like that? Why this mixed feeling is making me confused between things? Please help me if you can. If you are missing him, then I would say that to some extent you do have feelings for him. You might not be very obsessed with him, but if you are missing him, I would say a part of you is still connected to him. So what you can do in this situation is try to reconnect with him again. Explore things. Take your time. Just don't make decisions in, 1 week or 2 weeks. Take your time. Take few months and navigate through it. After quite quite a lot of months, I would say minimum 4 months, okay, and then see if things are working out. If things are working out, then well and good. If not, then I would say then you have to pay. Okay, it's already 20 minutes, so just few more questions. I think that's it for now. There are too many questions here. I will save that for my next video. So I think I should log off right now. It's quite a long video. So see you guys next time. I know I'm still quite nervous, you know, recording a video and all, and not very expert and speaking like an RJ or speaking the way professional YouTubers speak, but practice makes perfect, right? If I do this consistently, then I'm confident that I will reach that level. So just for newcomers here, you can subscribe to my channel and have a look at my previous videos also. So, and for old people who are already following me for a long time, I hope that this has been an interesting video here. And so stay tuned, I will see you very soon next time.